Reeds, Phragmites australis, a very well-known species, occurs around the planet. Occasionally, it'll germinate in areas of bare mud and grow up from seedlings, but in practice, that's exceedingly rare. The main way in which it grows is through underground roots, rhizomes, that then produce new stems that grow up. And that creates this dense mass of vegetation, this reed bed here. Also, at the bottom of the mud here, there's very little oxygen, making it difficult for the roots to function. But the reeds have aerenchyma, a tissue that takes air from the leaves into the roots, so the roots can then function. And they occur in nutrient-rich sites, so they grow fast. They might go 2 to 3 centimeters a day. So it's a very successful strategy. The bittern just called. Hear it? So the and it's a very good competitor. If you look at this reed bed, you can see there's almost nothing else growing. And that is because it grows densely, so that there's little light at the bottom of the vegetation. There's also decaying leaves. As you can see, there's leaf litter at the base here. So at the base of the vegetation, there's little exposed mud, and there's also a great mass of rhizomes. So it's very hard for other species to find places to germinate. So you tend to get single species reed beds. And because it grows so fast, and it's very good at extracting nitrates and phosphates from the water, it's very good at clearing the water of nutrients. And also because it takes the air from the leaves and pushes it down to the roots, it means there's oxygen in the root system, in the mud, and so microorganisms can grow and then break down the organic matter. So reed beds are great at clearing the water quality through reducing nutrients and breaking down organic matter. And sometimes they're used commercially for this. They're used as part of the process of sewage works and other areas where you need to clear the water. So this is a very successful strategy that reeds have. And so they're very widespread around the world. They're the most widely distributed angiosperm flowering plant in the world. And we know that species that are widely distributed tend to have more insects associated with them. So unsurprisingly, reed has more insects associated with it than any other perennial grass. And lots of interesting species, and also the water bodies, the insects will be falling in the water and feeding the freshwater system of fish and amphibians. They'll provide the base of the food chain that the bittern you can hear now will feed on. So it's an important area, habitat for conservation. The main challenge it has is this buildup of material, because it grows so fast and does so well, means that there's a buildup of organic matter, and so the reed bed will gradually dry up over time, and you'll have bushes growing. And if you look around, you can see a whole range of bushes growing, not a problem at low density. But left alone, a reed bed will tend to convert into shrubland and then woodland, and then lose its characteristic reed bed species. So what can be done about that? There's a number of possible options. One of which is to just let natural processes occur, except that some reed beds will go and others will be created elsewhere. The water recording, as a result of other systems occurring. So just allow natural systems to occur. But many people want to manage these systems. Traditionally, this has been done by cutting down the reeds, and the reeds are then used for the roofs of houses. And occasionally, that's rarely done on nature reserves, but sometimes that's done in order to set back the succession and remove the bushes. Burning is a process that used to be done, but that's not very popular. It can be grazed, so conic ponies are quite often used, water buffalo has been used. Around the world, there's a whole set of species that will occur in these habitats and create more disturbance, wild boar, for example. And then sometimes conservationists will take areas and remove the mud and vegetation in order to set back succession so the process will start again. So reed beds are a very characteristic habitat, important for clearing the water and important for conservation. But very often, if just left alone, they will convert into woodland. And very often these are then managed to ensure that they do persist.